from the barnyard to the kitchen to a happy life. Agriculture, it's kind of a good thing. Let me tell you about the little red hen. It's been Americanized, the story. Here it comes. Who will help me plant my wheat? Asked the little red hen. Not I, said the cow. Not I, said the duck. Not I, said the pig. Nor I, said the goose. But I'm going to do it all by my own self. So said the little red hen. And she did. And the wheat grew and it ripened, and pretty soon, hey, she said, who's going to help me reap my wheat? Not I, said the duck. It's out of my classification, said the pig. I'd lose my seniority, said the cow, and I'd lose my unemployment compensation, said the goose. And I'll do it by myself, said the little red hen. And so she did. Who will help me bake the bread? Asked the little red hen. That would be overtime for me, said the cow. I'd lose my welfare benefits, said the duck. I'm a dropout and I never learned how, said the pig. If I'm going to be the only helper, that's discrimination, said the goose. Then I'll do it all by myself, said the little red hen. And she baked 5 loaves of bread and she held them up when they were finished for all to see. And then guess what happened? You guessed it. They all wanted some. Hey, give me some. And no, I won't give you any. I'm going to eat all 5 loaves myself. Excess profits, cried the cow. Nancy Pelosi, capitalist leech, screamed the duck. Barbara Boxer, I demand equal rights, yelled the goose. Jesse Jackson, the pig, just grunted in disdain. Harry Reid. And they all painted unfair picket signs. And they marched around and around the little red hen, shouting obscenities. And the farmer, Obama, he finally showed up and he said to the little red hen, hey, you must not be so greedy. But I earned the bread. I did all of the work, said the little red hen. Exactly, said Barack the farmer. That's what makes our free enterprise system so darn wonderful. Anyone in the barnyard can earn as much as he wants. But under our modern government regulations, the productive workers must divide the fruit of their labor with those who are lazy and idle. And they all lived happily ever after, including the little red hen. She smiled and she clucked and she said, I'm grateful now, for now I get it. I finally understand. But her neighbors, they couldn't figure it out. They were disappointed in her. She never baked bread again, but hey, she was a good member now, in good standing of the Democrat Party, and everybody lived happily ever after, as said, but only for a little while, because someday, guess what? Everybody's gonna stop baking. We've all heard about too many cooks in the kitchen. Pretty soon, there's nobody in the kitchen under the socialist system.